My business is named Spade Landscaping. Here are my logos in some different colors. Anyways, my business operates out of Gahanna, and I offer landscaping and lawn care services. And I also work within the surrounding suburbs as well, such as Brownsburg, Blacklick, Westerville, New Albany. The primary three services that I offer include mowing, mulching, and overgrowth cleanup. That's where the majority of my income is made. However, some of my secondary services I offer include power washing, leaf cleanup, snow removal, flower bed construction, and several other things, although these are the primary ones, or the main ones right here. A little bit about the company. I officially founded it last year on February 14th. I figured Valentine's Day would be an easy day to remember. Pretty much a one-man operation right now. I kind of do everything myself, aside from hiring spot labor here and there to help me on certain jobs that are a little bigger. I've officially worked in the industry since ninth grade. However, before then, when I was in, I believe, middle school or junior high, me and my friends used to go out in the woods and build forts and do landscaping around our forts. And here's some pictures of that. We got a little stone path we made and some paths outlined with rocks and some plants and whatnot. And my current focus is primarily on residential clientele. However, I am open-minded to getting into the commercial side of the business. And when it's necessary, sometimes I do team up with other small landscaping businesses. For example, if I don't have the resources or the equipment to do certain jobs, I might reach out to somebody I know who does have that equipment and we'll team up on a job. That also applies to people that have other skills that I don't necessarily have. For example, hardscaping, which includes retaining walls and paver work. I don't really have a lot of experience with that. However, I get a lot of requests for that type of work. So instead of turning it down, it allows me to take on those jobs and create additional revenues. And I also have a partnership with two different realtors in the area, and that allows me to target new homeowners and people putting their houses on the market. So what I've found is that within the different demographics that I serve, for new homeowners, they tend to value speed the most. They want the job to be done quick because, you know, they got people coming to look at their properties. So that is something I can offer. I generally do have the capacity to start and finish jobs quickly. And then for my younger demographic, about ages 35 to 55, convenience is a big thing for them. They like the ability to be able to get online on their own time and, you know, either look at my Facebook page or a website to get information without having to actually call me or wait for me to show up on their front doorstep to tell them about things or to show them pictures of previous work. And something that I think is appreciated all around the board is quality, which is definitely something that I strive to offer. And that's just through putting a great deal of attention in every job that I take on. And then my older demographic, customer service tends to be really big for them. And I try to meet that need by always trying to be really friendly when I'm talking to new clients, present myself as knowledgeable about all the topics that they might have questions about. So some of the opportunities I found just here in Gahanna, and this was through the market share project we did, there's at least about 2,200 residential clients within Gahanna alone, and that's not even taking into account all the surrounding suburbs. That's generating approximately $3.7 million of revenue each year. And one thing I have found in the area is that the housing market does seem to be growing. I always see new houses sprouting up all over the place. So some of the ways that I'd like to meet those opportunities would just be simply spreading out marketing material throughout the local neighborhoods. That way people actually have my information and they can get in touch with me. Otherwise, they won't ever know about me and they're just gonna go find somebody else. And something that's absolutely vital is quick responses and answering phone calls. I've had times where I've just been busy for an hour or two after having gotten a phone call, called them back same day, maybe an hour later, and they've already, you know, they generally have three or four people's information sitting there when they're making phone calls. So if you don't answer that phone call, they're already moving on to the next guy. And anyways, dedication to making any complaints right, I think that's also critical. If you have a bunch of angry customers out there. They're going to spread a bunch of ill will about your business, and that's going to do nothing but bring you down. But if you have somebody that has a problem, you take care of it, then they're going to be doing your marketing for you through good word of mouth. So some of the limitations that I've found in my industry are just the simple fact that I can only drive so far to provide services to clients. There's been several instances where I've had to actually turn down work due to it just simply being too far away. For example, I'd say if a landscaping job is about 30 minutes away, that's probably pushing it. For mowing, it's a lot shorter than that even. Another thing, I definitely understand that there's a lot of reliable workers out there. However, for me, a lot of the people I work with currently, they also have other part-time jobs. So sometimes it can be a little tedious trying to coordinate with them, finding a day where we're both available, that the weather's cooperative to actually do a bigger job or need help. And then my own personal lack of experience just running a business, I've only been doing this for a short period of time, and that includes things such as setting the prices for different work, scheduling jobs where they don't overlap, taking care of various pieces of equipment, and just simply managing all the spot laborers that I have on the job. So some of the values from the services I offer include the features of completing services within a timely manner, and customers tend to enjoy that because they feel like their yards are being prioritized. They don't just feel like they're unimportant and being put on the back burner. And I always try to give very descriptive estimates to my clients. That way it's very broken down. Everybody knows exactly what they're paying for. And they don't feel like I just picked some number out of a hat and that's what they're getting charged. And as mentioned already, I try to put into every job a great deal of attention to detail. It allows clients to receive consistent quality, and you know, they don't feel like they're gambling every time they hire me. Like, is my yard gonna look nice? Is it gonna look like crap? So I try to be very consistent. So for the total market within the United States in 2016, and this has been pretty consistent since then, there's about $78 million of annual revenue, annual revenue being generated. And 49% of that comes from the residential side, which comes out to about $38.2 billion. And the industry is currently experiencing growth of about 4.8% each year. And including all the sole proprietorships and small businesses, there's a little over 500,000 landscaping businesses in the United States. So some of the challenges that I've found are just due to the fact that there's low barriers to entry. There comes a lot of competition, so that sometimes can be challenging to make yourself stand out. You know, you put your information on somebody's door, and that same day, three other companies come by and put their information on that door. So you gotta really strive to make yourself stand out from the crowd. And especially in the more northern states, a lot of the work we do is seasonal, so you either have to find alternative sources of income in the off seasons, or you have to make enough money during the warmer seasons to last you throughout the winter and late fall. You know, you're not gonna be mowing grass in the middle of the snow. So, and then I like to call them lowballers, but you have people out there that are just consistently charging very low prices, and that kind of drives down the market price a little bit. So you and some other people might think that jobs are worth this much when you get people charging this much, so then that brings down the customer's expectations of how much they're going to pay. So it kind of just hurts the industry. Okay, so my personal target market consists of homeowners living in or around Gahanna, which also includes new homeowners or people selling their houses, generally upper middle class and middle class, people with disposable income, which is the key. I mean, it doesn't matter what income class you are. You don't have disposable income. And we're looking at busy professionals, generally within the age range of 35 to 55. However, that can extend to, say, 65 just due to the retirement age. And we've got disabled or elderly individuals, generally around the age of 56 to 75. So my forecast of company growth, I'm expecting year one to do about 25,000. That could be a little low. I don't know, but I think it's probably pretty accurate. And then year two, I'm hoping to grow that by about 65%. And then the following year, I'm hoping for 35% growth. So my idea of an ideal client includes somebody who wants their yard mowed every week. And I would also like to have clustering in neighborhoods where you have a lot of clients within a short distance, so you don't have to travel real far to mow each yard. And I would like to seek out individuals that aren't too price sensitive, who have disposable income. And people that are competitive with their neighbors, I think they're very easy to sell to because you don't even have to try to upcharge these individuals. They are already completely on board with going all out on their projects because their entire goal is just to upstage their neighbors. And obviously people that are easygoing, friendly, and appreciative, I mean, everybody loves to work with people like that. And I definitely understand not all clients fit these categories, and I'm still willing to work with people outside of that. But to me, this would be ideal. And this is an example of somebody that I'd probably consider an ideal client. I did some work for them last year and asked them to write a review and wrote me a nice little review here. So for my competition, this is only a very small amount of competitors in Central Ohio. However, these are some of the main names out there. A few of them I will talk a little more about. So Brightview, they are actually the largest company in the United States. However, they do have a big presence here in Central Ohio as well. I've noticed that their primary focus seems to be on big commercial jobs. However, I have seen them in neighborhoods doing residential work as well. And they advertise online, they have a website, and I've seen them on social media as well. And they put their information out on their trucks. They got these big enclosed trailers, and they put all their information on the side of there real big. Windscapes is another pretty big company in the area. However, they're just located here in Ohio. And they've got a pretty mixed focus on commercial and residential work. I've seen them a lot in neighborhoods. And they have a pretty similar advertising and marketing campaign to Brightview, whereas I've seen that they have social media pages as well and a website, and they also put their information out on their trucks. And then this business here is ran by Nate Hall of Ray Landscaping. That's a pretty good representation of all the small businesses in the area, but he operates out of Gahanna. And his primary focus is on residential work. And he mainly just relies on word of mouth outside of having his information on the side of his truck. He hasn't really done any real marketing in a while. So for my positioning map, I pretty much put everybody up in this top quartile with just a little bit of variation. Brightview, I put a little lower in quality just due to the fact that they're such a big company. Sometimes quality control can be a little bit of an issue for the upper management. Whereas Windscapes, they're probably at a similar price point. However, since they're a smaller business and all their revenues are being generated in one area, which is Central Ohio, they've got to put in a little more work to make sure that their clientele is happy. Otherwise, it's going to be detrimental to their business. And for myself, I'm probably a little cheaper than they are. However, just due to the fact that I'm a small business and I can personally supervise each job, then it allows me to offer just a little bit more quality. And then for Ray Landscaping, I'd say it's pretty comparable quality. However, sometimes I think he might undercharge on certain jobs. And then just for reference, I just added this little neighborhood kid mowing lawns kind of towards this bottom quartile. You'd expect neighborhood kid to be kind of cheap, but you're not really expecting the best quality from that. So my competitive advantage, especially for a big business, is that I can provide more consistent quality just as a small business, as I've already mentioned, due to the fact that I can be on each job. And when it comes to competing with small business, I think having a professional appearance is a pretty big thing. I've noticed a lot of small businesses don't really emphasize this, and you don't really see many of them out there wearing any uniforms, whereas I make sure that is happening in my business. I do have uniforms. And I'm not claiming to be the most knowledgeable individual when it comes to all the work I do. However, I do go out of my way to research topics of any services that I offer. so that people will feel confident that they're dealing with somebody who knows what they're talking about. So for my business strategy, I generally try to market heavily in the late winter and early spring. You get a lot of, for mowing especially, you get a lot of people that, you know, the grass is just about to grow soon, and they want to make sure they have somebody lined up to mow it when it starts growing. And people, you know, the snow's starting to melt, they're coming outside and they start dreaming up all these ideas of what they want to do with their yards. And anyways, during the warmer seasons, such as spring and summer, that's when I want to push my three main services, which are mowing, mulching, and overgrowth cleanup, because that's generally the only time where you can really do those things. And then throughout the other parts of the year, I rely more on my secondary services, such as in the fall when nothing else is really going on, you got a leaf cleanup to help offset that seasonality. And then in the winter, you got snow removal. And then another strategy is to upsell your current clients. For example, if I am just strictly mowing somebody's yard, I might have the opportunity to convince them to start putting down some mulch. So for my online marketing plan, I do have a website. However, I plan to use search engine optimization to help draw in more traffic. And I have a Facebook page as well. And this is an example of one of the ads I'm going to be running on it. And then just for door-to-door marketing, I simply have business cards with all my information and some of my services, and I just hang these on doors. So for my break-even, right here, I took my three main services that I offer, and I got some averages here, and then I kind of broke down my monthly fixed costs. And then I use that information to come up with these numbers here. And if I'm going to do about 50% of my revenue from mowing, 30% from mulching, 20% from overgrowth cleanup, I have to generate about $600 from mowing, $960 in revenue from mulching, and about $2,500 from overgrowth cleanup. And from my experience, I think this is pretty easy to reach. And I briefly touched on this earlier, but for my three-year projection, I'm hoping to do about $25,000 the first year in revenue, which gives me about $6,600 in income, and then almost doubles, well, it's about a 65% jump, to $12,300 in year two, and then we have about $17,000 in year three. And then some additional considerations for that. And these numbers are solely based off my primary services, so I will be generating other revenues from other services as well, which should boost those numbers a little bit. And then this is also going to be a part-time business still while I'm in school, which is probably going to be the next few years or so. And additionally, for these numbers, I'm assuming that I'm using a lot of labor, whereas in reality, I'm probably going to be doing a lot of the work myself. So my labor expenses, that's probably just going to be going straight to me. So for funding, initially I started out with about $5,200, and since then I've been pretty self-sufficient, haven't really needed to go to outside sources for any money. However, I have received offers from family members to invest in the business, but I just haven't really needed to go that route yet. And then additionally, I could acquire bank loans or credit cards. I do have a Home Depot credit card, but I really just got that for the benefits. Every time I'm shopping there, I can get things like free gas. In summary, my company name is Spade Landscaping. My primary services are mowing, mulching, and overgrowth cleanup. Within Gahanna alone, there's at least 2,200 potential clients with about $3.7 million in annual revenue. And while there are a lot of competitors, I believe I can stand out enough to grow my company to reach or exceed my goals just by providing consistent quality to my clients. And that is it.